So NVIDIA is not only building high-end, more expensive processors like the Keplers and like the GPUs you might buy for gaming, but also really works very hard in the mobile arena. And so how is GPU computing going to influence that?
Well, it's not in our current shipping products, but the strategy, and it'll be available, you know, in the relatively near future, is to have the same GPU from top to the bottom of the line. And so, you know, eventually you will have a Kepler GPU in the Titan supercomputer, and you'll have a Kepler GPU in your cell phone. Sure. And you can apply the same programming models across that line and do GPU computing in your cell phone to the extent that it makes sense to do so.
So where do you see the most interesting applications going for things that you carry in your pocket?
You know, I think that the really compelling applications for mobile devices are in computational photography and computer vision. I think that, you know, photography is at this cusp of being completely transformed from something that you do primarily with lenses and optics to something you do primarily with computing. And a GPU is just a perfectly matched, you know, tool to basically do the type of image processing and signal processing you need to, you know, basically after you've collected a bunch of photons, to process them in a way to produce really compelling images.
So that sounds fairly abstract, and I think this is a fascinating field. Mm-hmm. So can you give an example of something that maybe a GPU would help you do in this computational photography realm?
You know, your little low-level things are like if you want to do high dynamic range images, you'll actually acquire a set of images. Then there's a bunch of problems in composing them together. The camera may have moved slightly between the images, so they have to be registered. There may be objects moving in the images, so even after you've registered the images, you have to back that object motion out to get the equivalent of a still photograph that was taken at one point in time. You may have what's called a rolling shutter, where because of the way the CCDs work, you expose one line of the image at a time, and so if there's any motion, that'll produce sort of a wavy action in the photo. You again have to remove that. And then you want to do some processing of those images to remove noise and to enhance the image. And then finally, to decide both when you acquired what exposure times you wanted to get an optimal high dynamic range image, and then how to combine those images into one final image that basically, you're given a limited gamut that you can display on your display device, gives the human who's viewing it the appearance of actually many orders of magnitude dynamic range from the original collected image. So bright areas of the image look bright, but not that bright,
not
because you don't
out.
Have, you know, that much dynamic range to actually display that.